Hope you're all still awake. Late Night Mega here. We still can't have entry without authorization. Well, let's check out this place since we're here. Is there anything up? Huh. There is something there. Ooh, restricted laboratory. Those are Metroids. And those are bigger Metroids that are actually kind of throwbacks from, that doesn't sound good. That doesn't sound good at all. It's, the SAX being attacked by Metroids. We gotta get out of here. These Metroids can block us, but otherwise isn't too hard to escape. And there goes the restricted area with Metroids that were anti-SAX, or anti-X-Parasite. There's, things that... Oh, navigation room. We should probably report in. Samus, you shouldn't have done that. You ignored your orders. You may have to pay a price for that quite soon. As you can see, the Federation has been secretly working on a Metroid breeding program. For peaceful application only, of course. Please understand, but perhaps you already knew of this program's existence. Certainly, you must have had doubts when you saw Sector 1, SRX, a faithful replica of the SR388 ecosystem. Ideal for raising Alpha, Gamma, Zeta, and even Omega Metroids. This research even uncovered techniques for rapid growth. Imagine, creating an Omega Metroid from a larval Metroid in days. But that research is finished. The X has smelled out its natural enemy, and one of the SAX is on its way here. One? Are you saying there's more than one SAX? I should not be giving Samus that deep of a voice. Don't be surprised, Samus. You know that the X reproduce by asexual division. Because of this mechanism, there are now no fewer than 10 SAX aboard the station. You'd think we'd be running into more of them. Samus, you must go. Get out. If you stay too long, the SAX will destroy you. Stop only at a navigation room to uplink to me. I don't know how HQ is going to take this, but you need to report to them immediately. Is your objective clear? Now get going. Alright, let's see if we can get that. We're not going to be able to get it. That'd be something we hit on collecting collectibles. The real Adam would have said the same thing about that incident, but he would have softened the blow. He was relentless in his criticism, but he always cared. He was not a machine obsessed with duty. No such compassion could exist in that computer. And we're back in Sector 1, which is a secret area of Sector 1, because we've been through Sector 2, 3... I think we gotta do this. Sector 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 again, since the whole... Have you guys... I'm still not hurt by the wave beam. Okay. Super missiles it is. Well, that didn't go as planned. We have acid, and these guys are back. Those appear almost to have some of the same properties as Metroids. Maybe they're like prototype Metroid thingies. I don't know. We're in a secret area. You know, a save station. That might not be a bad idea. And that takes us to get through, I think up there takes the screw attack? Or not. Hi there. These things can only be hurt from the back. They give a nice amount, but huge pain to take down. You have to take them down to trigger the opening on this door. I know I'm probably missing... I don't need to save again, we just did that. Probably missing some power up back there. And we'll get in on our way out. Really no purpose to battling those guys. This room's gonna be a pain in the butt. There we go. And that drops us down to... It's Ridley. The beam actually does decent damage to him. And then if you get caught, just launch a ton of missiles. Overall, not super tough for a Ridley battle. We'll change his pattern up a little bit here. I feel like the wave beam is does a lot better than missiles do in that area. Also made him look really easy there. I remember dying at least the first couple times, because I was trying to spam missiles, and I don't think I had nearly as many energy tanks. Where I just barely beat Ridley my first time playing this game. We got the screw attack, hooray! Yay, that lets us do this now. And we can defeat those guys. They have a name, but... Let's be real, no one cares what it is. And we can now make those guys a complete joke. The guys we just kind of struggled to beat, those golden pirates. We can collect a new upgrade, and now they're super simple to beat. That's kind of the story of Metroid Fusion. You run into something that's really challenging, really tough to beat, then you just get an ability like that, and they're easy. Oh, you're not going to be harder than the Golden Pirate. But with that, we have all of the abilities, so it's time to go do a little bit of the collecting collectibles. Now we can unlock that. Those take the screw attack to get through. That's why we had to go fight Ridley. Do you mind? I want to say he was Maybe he wasn't guarding anything. There should be something here. No? Okay. And these blocks also require the screw attack to get through. But that's okay. So just kind of a little bit of a workout for our screw attack. And the screw attack is good against that. If we can go around and collect stuff here. And yeah, I think we're gonna find out what hatched from that. We can probably figure it out. But in the meantime, we'll just go through here and regain or collect a bunch of stuff we were unable to collect the first time through. Hello. Speed, huh? We gotta get a speed booster through here. This one, I remember, is really annoying to deal with. Because essentially what we're going to have to do is run through several rooms here. And if we get hit, we get to do it all over again. Doesn't that sound so exciting? I don't remember what the upgrade is we get for this. Was it a missile? There we go. That's a power bomb. Yeah, that's not something you can get without having a bunch of abilities. Alright, let's see what else we can find. Wait a minute, isn't there? I could have swore there's a thing here. Aha! So to get this, you gotta be kind of on the tippy edge there. We'll do our run and fail. We don't have to. I thought we could get it by running through here. I could be wrong. I am very wrong. Oh, I know how we gotta get this one. We gotta use the same running path. Yeah, it is not the easiest thing in the world to get. Oh. What you have to do is you have to save your Shine Spark long enough to get up there, blast the door open, and that's not going to work. Screwing up a space jump will not get us the thing. It's probably just a power bomb or a missile, too. Might be an energy tank, who knows. Ha! And once you hit the ramp, go there. Oh, it was an energy tank. That's how you get that one. So yeah, there are at least a handful of really tricky upgrades to get in this game. I kind of appreciate that. And they're never super, super difficult to get where I don't really want to 100% the game because of them. Am I even going in the right way? Yes. Yes, I am. We got one more stop to do here. You guys remember this one where we failed to wall jump. Now we don't have to wall jump because we just do that. And it makes us happy. Yeah, if you're really good at wall jumping, you probably could have gotten that really early in the game. Like I said, they give us so many missiles and energy tank opportunities that missing a few of them won't hurt you. We've got a couple more places to check out here in Sector 1. And then we're going to head to the other sectors. And we're going to hope that we collect everything. So I'll see you for that.